Hi, I bet you have spent a lot of money in this past Halloween to buy fireworks and firecrackers. No worries, I'm here to help you make a very simple and safe firecracker that you can reuse, and it's much safer than what you can buy out there. It is actually one of my Iranian heritages I learned to make back there, among other things. But I mean, who can believe that something safe could come out of there? Anyways, to make these firecrackers, you need a few parts.
Darts, screws like these, some durable elastic band, and some regular matches. Welcome to Canada.
The first thing you need to do is to unscrew the head and rotate it and mount it on the tail by piercing into the tail. Well, never pierce a hole towards your body. This tail is a little bit tough, so I'm going to drill a hole into it.
Do not drill, pierce, cut, or do anything dangerous towards your body parts. And if you think the scene you just saw was so fake, lame, and unreal, then let me show you my hand.
This is a stab wound from many years ago when I tried to pierce open something with a knife and the knife tripped. And this one is also a stab wound, same day, half an hour from the first one, doing the exact same thing. And then, a few years later, I stabbed a 1-inch hole right into my wrist.
There is no escape from the enemy who lives within. That was deep, man!
Anyway, after making the hole, you can glue the head into the tail. It also helps to glue the fin because it tends to fall out often. Now you need a screw that fits loosely in the hole in the head and is longer than its depth. And then you have to tie the screw to the body of the dart with the elastic band. Here is the end result, and the elastic band keeps the screw in its place nicely.
Now let's make a new one differently. For this one, we don't need the tail of the dart. All we need is the head and a piece of wood like this. And we will hammer the head into the wood like this.
Here you go, son.
Thanks, Dad. You might want to have an adult hammer it for you. And now, of course, the elastic band and the screw need to go on. And here is how the new one looks like. Now I added a washer below the dart so that it doesn't split. Now we need to gather our charge, which is basically the flammable stuff at the end of the match. This stuff is quite safe and only ignites when you rub it against the sandpaper part of the matchbox. Don't play with matches.
To gather this material, you can basically use the dart and break off the material like this.
And here is how these work. You have to fill the dart with 2 to 3 matches worth of material and then you have to put the screw on nice and tight. Then you have to hit the screw on the head hard and the material in the dart make a small explosion and a big bang. This one you have to throw it onto a hard surface and that one you can hit it on the ground or on a wall. Just when you throw this one, make sure you don't hit anyone with it. Always remember, safety is my item number 2. The first one is fun. Let's try to discharge one with the hammer. I've already put the charge in and the screw and I'm gonna hit it with the hammer. Aiming the hammer is something that comes with experience. Go with smaller strokes. Let's go outside!
Now, you can do it with style.
You can do it with finesse.
You can do it with confidence.
Say what?